this period, I felt inspired by the 70s, which is something I never thought I would say. But for today, I decided to recreate a look from head to toe inspired by the 70s. I want to point out, this is not a perfect recreation of the look back then. It's more of my own interpretation of it. This is what I came up with. Let's get started. First step is to start by prepping your skin. I use a primer just so the makeup goes on smoothly. Number two, apply a base, either a BB cream or a foundation depending on how much coverage you want. And then I'm gonna go in with a concealer to cover any redness that I didn't cover before and my dark circles. Make sure you set everything up with just a bit of powder, and then you can move on to contouring, highlighting and adding blush. Try to make this step a bit more marked than you would usually do because the makeup back then wasn't as subtle as it is today, so feel free to go crazy. I also picked up a blush that is a bit more peachy and shimmery rather than pink. Onto brows, you want to have them very arched because that was the look back then, so I'm adding some powder on the very high point of them, and then I'm gonna brush them through and keep them kinda messy. Now we can focus on the eyes. Begin by taking a dark green shade and put it on your socket just to add some definition. Then go on with a pinky shimmery color and put it on your eyelids and use it to kind of blend that green shade into your eyes. Using a smaller brush, take that same color and put it on the inner corners of your eyes to add brightness. And then take an orange shade, a very matte one, and place this under your eyes all the way to the outer corners and blend. Now that the base is done, we're gonna go for a crazy black cat eye. You kinda wanna make it very, very thick, so don't worry if you mess up. You can just cover it up with more eyeliner. It's totally fine. Finally, curl your eyelashes and put on a very bold mascara, both on the top and the bottom. The final step is to pick a lipstick. Back then, nude lipsticks were huge, but I'm gonna go with a darker nude shade, kind of like a brown, because I want a bold look. Your makeup is now done, so we can move on to the hair. At the time, huge, fluffy hair were very important. But today, I'm gonna brush through my hair, add some dry shampoo just to help the roots. I'm gonna spray some heat protectant, and then I'm gonna take very tiny section of hair and curl it with my curling iron, just to get very tight curls. When you're done with all your head, you can pass your fingers through, and then I'm gonna give it a side parting very deep by flipping my hair on the side, and then set it all up with some hairspray, and you're done. So this is what I came up with for this month of Marzia style. Every month I will be taking one specific theme and creating a look head to toe. So if you have any suggestion for me, leave them down below and I might do it next month. But for now, I hope you enjoy it and I will see you very soon. Bye!
Thanks for watching!